I thought I felt a shiver, but it was only an earthquake on my empty page. Only an earthquake on my empty page. And I thought of the passing of planes and people, of the Star-Spangled Banner with New York burning, and Bush voyaging, ducking missiles in his mind. Full of empty rhetoric, ravaged by Cold War paranoia, and tied to the hypocrisy of Sunday school golf, with reds in the bed and hippies smoking reefer.
And the growing police state.
scrutinized by a neighborhood watch, while the lonely are left to their fate. The lonely are left to their fate. Minimal brain dysfunction, a nasty name used without compunction, a nasty name for naughty boys or children with minds of their own. Attention deficit disorder, a new name for an old problem. Controlling parents and teachers, intelligent but bored children. Now given drugs, amphetamine speed, they call them stimulants and give them to the toddlers. They give them to the toddlers. The acknowledged experts on children are flawed by a serious prejudice. They still believe that children should be seen and not heard. Seen and unheard. Minimal brain dysfunction, a nasty name used without compunction, a nasty name for naughty boys or children with minds of their own. Attention deficit disorder. But not of repression. They talk of depression, but not of repression.
His soul to the men wielding power as he
rose like hot wind up the ivory tower. To be master of the mask, he smiles with guile as the mercenaries file past. The managers build the ladder to the top of the tower. A dangling carrot leads them higher and higher.
To watch the TV, he claimed that we would finally see reality, under the impression that Ruth is not a digression. I had to ask the question as to why the strange things I saw that night. Time disguised as real and right. So I waited for the commercial break to lose my concentration as my attention wandered away from the packet filled with cornflakes on the screen to reality as it has been. From the cornflakes on the screen to reality as it has been.
Philosophizes and worries about whether he has been logical. Andrew is a gentle soul. He converses honestly than worries about whether he has offended anyone. Andrew is a gentle soul. He swallows his tablets and worries about why he feels so ill. He thinks about his memory and worries that he can't remember what happened when they first locked him up and gave him electric shocks. Andrew wishes that his brain would recover from the cruel torture. John studied philosophy. He wrote throughout the night. He wrote about freedom of speech. John went to university, to the philosophy faculty, to develop, he hoped, his mental faculties. His mental faculties were full of freedom. The university faculties were not. John felt free to debate. He felt free to argue the point of freedom with his professor. The professor did not agree. The professor became angry. The rule here is clear. Students respect their elders. That is the rule here. That is the rule here, said the professor. John was diagnosed. He was institutionalized. He was drugged, but not broken. He now shows compliance. He complies with the poisons under threat of injection, but waits for the day he will be free to speak his mind without dribbling, and walk steadily without shaking. Dean is just a child, a just child. Misdiagnosed as defective because he twitches when he talks of atoms and music. He has a tic when he talks of time and history, mythology and cosmology. He has a tic when he talks of time and history. Tourette's syndrome, claimed the experts, is caused by chemical imbalances with genes behind the scenes, a pseudoscience lurking. To label Dean inferior and bring him under control and bring him under control. Independent, creative, witty children surely can be better treated with love than labels. Music than medication, hugs than drugs, hugs rather than drugs. Thank you.
was shaken. He was sure he was divine. He sang about smiling. He sang about smiling. The colors and the fine line between madness and sanity. He sang about the fine line between compliance and control, treatment and torture. Michael was shaking because the drugs make him shake. He was suffering, but laughed at the poison. Zoopanthic saw, a zoopanthic saw me. A zoopanthic saw he chortled. They think we're zoo animals, but they come to keep me down. They know I'm special. They know of my power. They know of my special ability to laugh and make people laugh and sing. I have the special ability to make people sing. I'm a musician. I'm a musician. They can cripple my hands. They can't cripple my head. They can't cripple my head. They can cripple my hands, but they can't cripple my head. Patients weep, and why his patients cannot sleep. They ask him why his wallet swells when people living hands. He justifies with lies and tricks to show his victims that they are really, really sick. Those he tortures are truly ill and in need of a poison pill. left and I wear. Yesterday I talked and I slept. I listened with enjoyment. I listened with love. I listened with anger and I listen with dismay. I observed in silence and I spoke out loud. I spoke from the heart things I hadn't said before. I spoke from the heart because my heart was sore.
Freedom, and I spoke of peace. I spoke of revenge and reconciliation. I heard what happened to the Aboriginal nation. I said I thought they deserved compensation. I spoke of miners and their place in the southern land. I spoke of uranium. Sand. I spoke of the times I played in a band. I spoke of relationships and marriage and children. I spoke of dishonesty and I spoke of Bill Clinton. I listened in anguish to new talk of war. I closed my eyes to the headlines I saw. Most of the day, I sat there in silence and thought about ways we can stop all this violence.